John, this is the time of year we stay inside and just thank the air conditioning gods.
Don't you know that's true? Man, I hope everybody's air conditioner is working full tilt boogie because, oh my goodness,
otherwise
110 feels like, oh yeah, so humid out there. We had 97 degrees in Punta Gorda today.
That's 97. Unbelievable.
Wow. I know. Factor in the feels like temperature and oh my goodness, worse than that. Right now, we have feels like temperatures across the region in the mid 90s still. With an 86 degree actual air temperature, dew point coming in at 75, north northwest wind coming in at about 5. As we head into the nighttime hours, we'll see these temperatures, which are right now hovering around 85, 86, 87 degrees, probably bottom out only about 5 or 6 degrees cooler than they are right now. And the reason for that is all the humidity that's in the air. Now, that said, we did have a little bit of drier air work its way in earlier on today, and I think that that probably helped produce some of the gusty winds associated with one thunderstorm cell between Parrish and Palmetto in Bradenton today. It produced some very gusty winds. In fact, I looked at some Doppler radar estimates of winds, and it came in at over 70 miles an hour. That one gust didn't last very long. It's probably a wet microburst, they call it, which is where some drier air kind of filters into the downdraft of a thunderstorm and helps to cool that air, making it heavier and denser, and then it just plummets to the ground, hits the ground, and spills out, creating that kind of gusty wind that actually flipped a few 18-wheelers and snapped a couple of trees. So some pretty big storminess in Bradenton today. But it was inland, as is all of the rain shower activity that we have seen today. So if you live along the coast, you might think, well, what's this about rainfall? I'm not seeing any in my house. And you probably won't either as we head into the weekend. One shower now closing in on Arcadia. You can see that right there. In about a half an hour, you'll get some rainfall there. And then down to the south, another cluster of storms may bring some rain shower activity to Punta Gorda. There's that one storm moving generally to the west or to the northwest as the sea breeze begins to collapse. And then this one down to the south also moving in a general direction toward Punta Gorda. But again, both of these storms are kind of falling apart, so they don't have a lot of life left in them. High pressure remains our dominant weather feature over the next several days, just as it was today. It noses across the center part of the state, reducing our rain shower chances. It also brings us very light and variable winds, such that that sea breeze starts, builds, moves inland a good distance, and creates the kind of trigger mechanism for the showers and thunderstorms that build later in the afternoon. We have a chance of some severe weather to the north of us. Talk about that in just a minute. Tomorrow, maybe a few storms around a little bit closer to the coast as the winds get a little bit lighter. Over the next several days, that high kind of meanders back and forth and across the center part of the state. And it changes our rain chances no more than about 10%, really. Very warm afternoons, light and variable winds. We're still in this bit of a dry spell, and that'll probably go on right straight through the weekend. RPM computer model shows those showers building in inland areas. Again, tomorrow mostly kind of dying out there as well as they try to make it back to the coast as the sea breeze collapses. Don't think we'll see a lot of activity near the coast, but a few of them may make it a little bit closer than we saw today. There's the bullseye for severe weather. If you're traveling to Minneapolis, down to St. Louis, up to Chicago tomorrow, there certainly could be some airport delays because of weather. West wind at about 10 knots will bring you a light chop tomorrow. And as we head into the next 7 days, our rain chances only go up minimally, and we stay warm again tomorrow.